what's up guys, this video I'm gonna show a new, or like a new and improved Grid Scrim deck. I feel like I saw the deck already last season. I'm not really sure if I did a video already about that, but Rero, one of the best Grid Scrim players, or like the best Grid Scrim player with this deck. Two seasons ago he had like 3 accounts to top 10. Last season he had like 2 or 3 accounts to top 20, top 30. I'm not really sure, but he is for sure the best Grid Scrim player. Normally he had a band in it, but he put it Dark Winds in, I think because there are a lot of barbarians, and you really prefer to have the Dark Winds in some matchups against Sparky as well. So it's a new and improved Grid Scrim deck. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for free, and don't forget to put code MOD in the shop. I really appreciate all the support, and I'm gonna see you in the first top ladder game. Let's go. So guys, here the first game against FCB Dan. This guy is a Balloon Freeze player. He basically a really interesting off mana deck with the Mega Knight as well. So we're going with a Bubble to start off the game, and then we're gonna go with Inferno Dragon in the back, and let's see how he's gonna respond to that. So he could go opposite lane with a Balloon, but we have to Ramble, or he's gonna go same lane with Balloon. This could be interesting. So we're going with this. Then we're going with a Heal Spirit over here. The Balloon should get a one hit. No, it's not even get a hit. Oh my goodness, let's go. And the Ramble is charging. The Inferno Dragon is not doing his job, and it should be towered on. Oh my goodness. He freezed really aggressively. That's why I played immediately. I immediately played a Lumberjack on his Hunter. That my Hunter is able to... And it is, that my Lumberjack is able to kill his Hunter and not splashing my troops anymore. Because otherwise, the Hunter would have killed the Inferno Dragon, would have damaged the Ram Rider, and we wouldn't have had the counter push. So right now we're in a really solid position here. And he is going to drop a Mega in the back. Like, the big disadvantage against with this deck, like the only big disadvantage in my opinion, is that you don't have Ice Grim, so it's really hard to win against Pekka. And any sort of deck which you need, where you need to kite troops to the opposite lane. So we need to go for Bubble over here. Bubble is perfectly played, and I don't think the Mega is gonna jump if we are lucky. No, it's not gonna jump. Really good defense pass. Perfect. Okay, we're just gonna wait. I think we can go with a Magic Arch in the back. We have to be careful with the freeze. With the Mega Knight, a big Mega Knight Balloon push could be annoying because we don't have Ice Grim, so we can't kite to the opposite lane and separate this both win conditions from him. So we need to go for another Magic Arch in the back. And let's see. He's gonna go for Inferno Dragon in the back. I think we're just gonna do the same. We can do the same, bro. We go with Inferno Dragon as well. So let's see what he does. He's gonna drop the MK in the back. So we're going for Heal Spirit, just healing everything up. If he's gonna go for Hunter, we're just gonna fireball Bubble this, because now he's no way to kill this actually. And then we can even go with a Ram Rider. And then we go with a Heal Spirit to healing everything up. Or can we heal everything up? It would be great. No, we can't. Okay, yes, we can now. And okay, it's a Inferno Dragon die, so this is fine. So we need to go for Magic Archer. If he's gonna go for Balloon, we have Fireball. Keep it going like this. And then we go with this. If he's gonna freeze, I think we played it far enough away. Come on, bro, come on! Oh, that was perfect. Really clean defense pass. Gonna Heal Spirit this. And this should be fine. Going with it like that. Going for Darkness on that, and we're gonna take the first W in this video. I'm gonna see you next game. Let's go, guys. Let's hear another game against a Chinese opponent. So I'm just gonna go with Magic Archer in back. My starting move, my favorite starting move, is going with Bubble or Magic Archer in the back. He's going for Heal Spirit, so this could be a lot. Could be Warrior Line. Could be a Graveyard Bubble deck. Yeah, there's some. Okay, with the Fireball. It could be Bridge Ram as well, if I'm honest. No, it's not. Okay, Dark Winds. Like, Fisherman is so broken, the Dark Winds charge got, just gets reset with the Fisherman, so this is kind of annoying. Okay, let's see, what is he gonna do now? I think we're going opposite lane here. Why are we going opposite? Because if he has no Barbarian Cycle. Yes, Pekka, what the? What's this deck? Why would you have Pekka with E-Drake? Oh man, this is like a... Feels like a snipe. Going for Darkness over here. Darkness is tanking. Enough hits. We're going with a late Bubble to kill his Pekka and to kill his... Oh, this is annoying. He's still in a damage advantage, but still. He has like E-Drake, Packer, Fireball, Heal Spirit. What's his win condition? You don't really want to see decks like that. Okay, bro. What's the plan from now on? We could go with Inferno Dragon in the back. Does he have a reset against it besides Electro Dragon? We're going with Inferno Dragon against the Santa. And if he's gonna go for Electro Dragon, we need to Fireball this. Yes, we need to Fireball this. Or... this is really annoying, not gonna lie. Oh, he messed up the, what is this called? What's his name? The Heal Spirit. Yeah, but it's not gonna touch it. Man, he has everything. It's like a complete hard count. He has P.E.K.K.A. You have, don't have any anything against P.E.K.K.A. He has Fireball against Magic Archer, Fisher against Ram Rider. Hunter's really good against Bitrim as well. This was so important we kept it alive. And go for Ram Rider in front. Can this all die maybe? It's going with P.E.K.K.A. at the bridge. But I don't think that was the plan. Man, I knew it! I knew he's gonna go with P.E.K.K.A. at the bridge. Like, this is like the best move against my deck. You go with Batman in the with Rambo in the back, P.E.K.K.A. at the bridge. I can't defend this. That's why I went with Darkness opposite lane. And immediately I saw the P.E.K.K.A. I went with the Lumberjack opposite because I knew I can buy time with the Barber, with the Heal Spirit to distract. And we take the W against. What the fuck? I don't really know what this deck is, but we were able to win it. Let's go! Guys, your next game, we play against Carby, I think, and this is like a really toxic and tough matchup for us to win. So, P.E.K.K.A. is tough against the best P.E.K.K.A. players, even tougher, if you can say it like that. So, we want to go for Darkness against his Battle Ram. And then we want to go with a Magic Archer on his Magic Archer. His build was great. And we think we should get a Darkwind charge here. No, we don't. Messed up the bed a bit. But shouldn't matter too much. We're going with a Barber in front of that. Because he will go with P.E.K.K.A. now. Oh, he just goes with the Royal Ghost. It's fine too. Okay, so far so good. But it's gonna be hard to defend. This is really hard to defend. He's going with a Battle Ram once again in the back. We need to go with the Magic Archer. Going for Heal Spirit here to heal it up, and I hope it's gonna charge. Come on, bro, charge. No, it's not, okay. We need to go for Barbel over here. Barbel is killing the bandit. Flawless, perfect. And then we can go with a Dark Prince against his Ram Rider. Against his Royal Ghost. Okay, this is looking good. Going with a Magic Archer at the bridge, chipping away a bit at his tower. Oh, that was a bad bridge fight. That was a bad bridge fight. He's still gonna zap it. So we get some chip, but it was... it looked better than it was, to be honest. It was a mistake by my end. I thought like the Magic Archer would survive longer. So we need to get a ton of Inferno Dragon in this matchup. Inferno Dragon value in this matchup. This. What's he going to do against this? We need to go for Dark Wind. And then I think the Inferno Dragon should clean everything up. Yes. Perfect. I think we need to go for Magic Archer over here just to catch some chip at least. hier geht's. One pack ahead. Okay, we need to go for Lumberjack in front of this. Go for Barbell opposite lane to pressure him on both sides. We need to Firebolt this. To go for Ram Rider. No, don't splash, dude! If you know, he needs two poisons. Oh no, don't, I see you need two poisons after the change. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. So close. I think we played it insane. I think we both played it really, really well, and I'm gonna show you the game. I think it was a really nice game to show for you guys, and I think we do one more game. Come on, we do one more game, and we'll see you in the last game for this episode. Let's go. It's your last game for this episode against Reborn, and we're just going for Barbell at the bridge and pressure him a bit. He's just gonna go for Magic Archer as a respond, so I just hope it's not Pekka again. Going for great fireball on that, getting some chip with the Barbell, so far, so good. He's going with the Barbell, so it looks like it's gonna be a mirror matchup because normally Pekka doesn't have Barbell. And he has a Darkness as well, so it's gonna be a mirror. Maybe it's even another account from Vero, so let's see. Going for Magic actually defensively. Yeah, perfect. We're going for Infern Tank defensive now. He's just gonna spam me now, I think. Yes, he does. We need to go for Barbell, we need to go for Heal over here. And heal everything. But I think the defense was not too bad. We need to go with a Ram Rider in front of this. Can Ram Rider tank? Yes. He needs to go for Fireball, he needs to go with a... Oh, it's fine, okay. He plays it really, really well. So, a key in this matchup is if you have Inferno Dragon on the field, you always get pressure because if your opponent is responding to the Inferno Dragon, like you're into a Rambite, the Inferno Dragon is burning the tube away. So, the advantage right now is we can go with a Magic Archer in the back, and he can't because we have Fireball. Let's see if he's still gonna do the same. He's gonna go for Inferno Dragon. So, we're just gonna do the same. Fireball over here just to push it back, and then we go for Darkmoons in front of it because you always want to develop the order. So we're going for Heal Spirit over here, and the Darkmoons. Oh, the Darkmoons is even splashing. I don't really know how this happened, but it happened. And it's Fernding. Okay, it's not gonna log into a tower, but right now the boy should be in Fireball range to be dead. Magic Archer at the bridge and going with the Heal Spirit. The Heal Spirit is gonna lock on. That should be a ton of damage. The Rambite is even connecting. Perfect. Rambite is still at the tower. And Feldrang is tanking for that. One more hit. Oh no. So we need to go for Darkmoons in the back now. He's going aggressive. I hope we can defend this. We need to go for Fireball defensively. We need to go for Fireball defensively. We're gonna take the dive against Reborn. I don't know if it is well, but we got the win. Plus 24 trophies. Let's go. Really, really nice episode. We are currently Top 50 global. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to put good morning in the shop, and I'm gonna see you in one of my next videos. Peace out and goodbye.